Hey, welcome to my friends. Today I'm going to discuss nested for loop. Nested for loop actually used to design different types of patterns, matrix, and many more. If you like this video, then share and subscribe. First of all, I describe what is loop. In programming, a loop is used to repeat a block of code until the specified condition is met. In C programming, there are three types: loop, for loop, while loop, and do while loop. In this video, I describe only for loop. This is the general format of the for loop. In for loop, first of all, I write initialization, semicolon, condition, semicolon, increment. You just see that each of the statement in for loop separated by semicolon. After that, we write the block of the for loop by using the second bracket. In second bracket, we define the body of the loop. This is a simple example of the for loop, that is for I equal to 0, semicolon I less than 10, semicolon I plus plus, and we print the hello world. This message has been printed in 10 times. Now I describe the nested for loop. Nested loop means a loop statement inside another loop statement. That is why nested loops are also called as loop inside loop. There are a simple examples of the nested loop. This is called outer loop and this is called inner loop. Outer for loop, if this condition is true, then we go to the inner for loop. I again repeat that this for loop is called outer loop and this for loop is called inner loop. If outer loop condition is true, then we go to the inner loop, and inner loop condition is true, then we get the value of I and J. When we printing the value of I and J, we must give the slash n condition. Slash n means it's printing the new line. In this for loop, we get the output of in matrix form. Using this loop, we can create 3x3 matrix. This is the examples of 3x3 matrix, and this is the coding of the nested loop. This is the outer loop, this is the inner loop. If the condition I less than 3 in outer loop is true, then it go to the inner loop. And inner loop, J value has been executed for J equal to 0, 1, 2. Here we decoding the output, that is when I equal to 0, 0 less than 3, this condition true, it goes to inner loop and we get the value of J equal to 0, 1, 2. When J equal to 3, condition is false, it goes to the outside of the loop and we get the value 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2. When it goes to the outside of the loop, it prints the value of n. N means printing from new length, that is, we can start in from new length. And when I get I equal to 1, that is 1 less than 3, after incrementing the value of I, 1 less than 3, it again goes to the inner loop and we again get the value of J equal to 0, 1, 2, and we again get the value 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2. Similarly, we again get the value of I equal to 2 after incrementing the value of I, that is 2 less than 3, correction is true, and it again goes to inside loop and we again get the same patterns. That is J equal to 0, 1, 2. Combined with this value, we get 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2. This is the output of these programs. And we see that programs printing as matrix forms. If you like this video, then kindly share and subscribe. Using the nested loop, we also print sometimes diagonal loop matrix. That is 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2. We just do it by using this simple condition J less than equal to I, that is when I equal to 0, 0 less than 3, question is true, then it go to the inside loop J equal to 0, J less than equal to I, that is 0 less than equal to 0, that means 0, 0 printed. When it incrementing I value equal to 1, 1 less than 3, question true, it again goes to the inner loop 1 less than, that is J equal to 0, J equal to 1, we get the value 1, 0, 1, 1. After incrementing the value of I equal to 2, we get in a loop and we get the value again, the 202122, and we get the value like patterns. Using a nested loop, we can print this pattern *****, just writing inside the print a star statement, and other code segments are same. Here is another pattern. Here value of k equal to 1 is slice. After each time the outer loop and inner loop are executed, the value of k is incremented, and we print the value k equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 in this cell. That is, when I equal to 0, 0 less than 3, then condition of the outer loop has been executed and it goes to the inner loop, and j equal to 0 again, that is 0 cell, we print the value k equal to 1. Then value of k is incremented and the loop is terminated, it again goes to the outer loop, that is I equal to 1 after incrementing I plus plus, 1 less than 3, and again it goes to the inner loop, j equal to 0, j equal to 0, j equal to 1, we get this value, and inside this value we again printed value k equal to 2 and 3. Proceeding in this way, we get matrix. Now I show that it printed even odd patterns, that is, when k equal to 1, 1% is 2. Now we know that 1 is even odd numbers, 2 is even numbers, 3 is odd numbers, 4 is even numbers. In this way, just print 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. This is a simple program that has been executed in Turbo C++ 4.5. And using this way, we implemented many patterns. If you like this video, then share and subscribe. If you have any confusions, then write in the comment section. Thank you very much.